Okay, here I am again, and on this video I'm also going to do a puddle pour and a flip cup. Today I'm going to use a red, a very bright yellow, and all these colors have my recipe for pouring medium, flow trowel, and blaster silicone. We've got an orange. These are colors that I created. And then we've got a black. I like the flamey feel of these colors, so that's what we're doing today. So let's start with pouring our flip cup. I'm gonna put a little bit of black in the bottom of the cup, quite a bit of red, a little orange. A little of the yellow. More red on top. Black. Orange. A little yellow. Red, I think that's all I'm going to put. I'm going to go ahead and flip it. I'm going to put black around the exterior of it. If I have to make some more black for my puddle pour, I will. I want to make sure we get color on the edges. I can always come back and paint the sides black if I don't quite get enough. Push these out a little bit. I always like doing these fiery combinations. If it's water or fire, it's something that I dig. So y'all see me do a lot of variations on this kind of stuff until I get bored with it and decide to do something else. So for now, it is what it is. Okay, scrape that off. Waste not, want not. Go along my edges a little bit here. Okay. So, I'm going to move this canvas out of the way, and I'm going to find me a pen, which I have over here somewhere. I don't know. Where are my pens? There. Okay. And I'm going to release the Kraken. A little airflow. Again, like I say, the paintings make themselves. As you can see, very little effort on my part. I'm just letting the paint know which part of the canvas needs some attention. That's all. I love this. I absolutely love it. Very happy with the way this is coming, but I want to put a little more black because I want to keep that movement steady. So So it needs that black to allow it to continue to glide freely. Wow, nice. I love it. I'm almost afraid to release the cup. Almost don't want to. And I did. Premature release. Look, I sprayed silicone on the cup before we started. That's what allowed that motion to be so effortless. Now, since I need to get my sides covered and I want to make sure that the whole piece is cohesive, I'm checking my sides here. I'm going to be doing a little bit of tilting this direction because this side over here is just totally without. But I'm going to tap my sides gently with the paint that's on my hands, and if I need a little more, I can get up on the edge and get it. This way I'm going to guarantee that I've got a little coverage on all of it. And then I'm going to come back with the torch. We're going to see if we can coax some of that silicone up, maybe create some bigger cells before we move the canvas tilted. And I may not tilt this one. I'm kind of digging what I've got here, and I'm real curious to see how the puddle pour is going to complement this piece. I like the idea of doing these twin sets. That done at the same time. Okay, so now let me wipe my hands. I lose my paper towel. Yeah. Price we pay. And I'm going to torch this. Not too much though. I don't want to mess up what we got going on, but I do want to coax the silicone to the surface. I'm digging this piece a lot. Okay. So, here we go. I'm going to tilt this way first, just a touch. And then back this way. I just wanted it to run off the canvas here. And that's it. I'm happy. I like this. Oh, I dropped a little drip of black there. But that's happy accident, as the great once said. We all watched him. Don't even lie. Don't even try to pretend you didn't. Happy little accident. Oh my gosh, I love this. It has the feel of electricity. I love it. All right. Now, I am going to move this aside. Take a few cups over to where I'm going to sit it. And pardon my shuffling feet, but I have on slippers today. Over here, hopefully it'll fit there where I want to move it to. And my puppy just busted in on me. This is a puppy. Oh my gosh, what a beautiful piece. Okay, taking that out of the frame, I'm gonna come around and I'm making some more black, because now we're going to do with the exact same colors on this next canvas, we're going to do a puddle pour. So I need some more black. Wasn't that gorgeous, y'all? I hope you liked it as much as I did. I loved it. And I will confess to you that my black has a little touch of blue in it from an earlier pour. That's the thing about black. You can use your plain Jane basic black, or you can give it more depth and dimension by adding blue, purple, even a green, a red. It needs to be a little thinner. You get more dimension. You get more depth to your piece by doing that. So, all right, we're going to cross our fingers that this piece comes out as cool and as complementary to the other piece as my earlier twin set did. Those beautiful metallic blues and copper with the white, beautiful. Came out beautiful. All right, so I'm going to start this pour with a little orange. I'm starting more over to the left side of my panel because my room tends to tilt that direction just a little bit, so might as well take advantage of work with what you got. I like working in threes with this style right here. When I watch Millie D do it, it always seems to come out really good. Now, I'm not claiming for one moment that I have any of the skills that girl has with these puddle pours. There's something about the stuff she creates. It has this organic perfection when she puts her hands on a canvas and starts to make it move. She makes magic happen, and it impresses me, I have to say. Shout out Millie D if you're watching me. I do love what you do. I really, really dig it. I'm gonna try to do more of a curvy, swervy tilting of the canvas on this next time, because I'm really not wanting that stripy feel, you know? I hope y'all follow what I'm talking about, that I don't like the stripiness that Winky Brat, what are you doing? I hope you're not over there getting into stuff that I just freshly painted. I hope not. I hope not. You better not. Sorry, y'all, I'm actually talking to my dog. This yellow is really vibrant. Kind of looking like a psychedelic butterfly. Ooh, I can't put black in on top of that yellow, because if I do that, more than likely I may end up with a green. We don't want green. Using up the rest of the paint here. Just help everything move and glide. Go with this puddle pour. loving this one. Make sure my corners are covered. Wow. Groovy, baby. Groovy. Yeah. That's what I'm talking about. Love it. Love it, love it, love it. We're going to torch it. Trust me. If I learn nothing from Anne-Marie Ritterhoff, you gotta torch it. At least part of it. Sometimes I think you can overdo it, torching. I really do. I think some pieces are probably more fantastic if they're not torched, but some just kind of have to be. So, we're torching. It's not really reacting. That's funny because it does have silicone. Here we go. Now we're getting it. That black wants to react. Come on, black. Do your fiery business. Come on, torch. You can do it. Nope. It says no is done. All right. Oh, we got a little smoke. Oh, I love this. The sails I'm getting over here. I'm wondering if I can stretch those. I'm wondering. Oh, Shannon, do you do it? Hmm. I love this over here. Not this so much, but I love that. So if I tilt to get rid of this, I'll lose that too. Hmm. I so want to stretch this if it's stretchable. We'll see if it will do any stretching. Did. Yeah. I dig it. I hope it looks as good with the other piece as the other twin set pieces did. This is cool. Okay, guys. Oh, I got a corner not covered, but I've got some spots on that side that need a little attention. I really hate this yellow right here. There's just too much of it. Other people may love it. You know, you never know. And now, that's better. Yeah, I can live with that. All right, that's the end of it, folks. Thanks for watching. Keep painting.